their friends and family. Delano and Stephanie have come to offer themselves to God and to each other in the holy bonds of marriage. Marriage is established, Delano, please look at her. Yeah. Marriage is established for welfare and or enjoyment. And marriage makes sacred the union between a man and a woman. We will offer to the both of you the opportunity to grow together in more complete manhood and womanhood. Marriage is also very special, and by extension, morning or not, tin mackerel or oxtail, stay in love.
Oh man, that is fantastic. Now, the question is though, have you ever heard of the 24 in 24 experience? Andrew, you can guess what that is?
I haven't heard of it, but I'm learning as I go, and I'm very impressed so far.
I'm very impressed, because joining us at the altar to tell us more is the CEO of MSW Events, Monique Shauna K. Walcott. Welcome to Sunrise.
Good morning.
How are you?
You gave my whole public name a while ago.
I guess we need to know what the MSW is for. Monique, what is happening in here this morning? Walk us through this.
What is happening is a taste of what is to come for June 14th, 2024.
Yes.
So back 10 years ago, and we're celebrating 10 years since we did our first mass wedding, celebrating love.
Yes.
That is what it is about. And today we have two of our amazing couples that have already been selected for this year's staging.
Awesome.
And their love story is one that will have you in tears, have you laughing. And that's what we're looking for.
Yeah.
We're looking for couples to share their love story and why they deserve this free mass wedding. And when I say free, I mean absolutely free.
Ooh, really?
All you need to do is share your love with us. Tell us your love story. What makes you laugh? What gives you the butterflies? Ooh. What makes you know that this is your person for life?
Oh, wow.
Ladies and gentlemen, she said free.
Free.
At the risk of sounding redundant, because you took less than 5 minutes to transform this space into, but tell us what it is like to set this up for 24 couples. Walk us through that.
It would be impossible to do it by myself. And so we have had over the years amazing vendors that have worked with us in the event and wedding industry. So today, even the chairs, the setting, etc., was sponsored by one of our sponsors who is on board and ready to take on four of the couples.
Oh, nice.
And she will be outfitting them, and that is Design Views by Nika. And believe me when I tell you, she is ready. She's looking at all the luxury, and we invite other vendors to come on board. Mm-hmm. If you have a product that is geared towards wedding and events, here is a platform to showcase your talent. Jamaica is filled with talented people.
Oh yeah.
I mean, it's not just in our music, it's in our food, it's in the way we talk, the way we dance. We're just about love and artistic views, and we want to share that. We want to show that. The only thing that's different this year than what we did in 2014 is that in 2014 we opened it just to Jamaica. This year we open it to the diaspora. So the Caribbean, the UK, Canada, the US, they'll all be able to participate, send in their love stories to get a chance to really enjoy the luxury of Jamaica and just how we share our love, style our love, sell our love.
Nice.
So for the person who is watching this who's just like, wait a minute, this could be our opportunity to have our wedding, but they might be like, but this sounds like it could be a logistic nightmare.
Right.
How do we marry 24 couples on the same day in the same setup?
Space.
In the same space?
Yeah.
Well, we have about four ministers. You would have just met one. And it is one beautiful ceremony of love just floating in the air.
Mm-hmm.
And so you'll have all the couples still individualizing the experience, because we're not going to take away your moment. This is still your moment. So each individual couple gets to pick their bouquet. Mm. They get to pick their colors.
Mm.
They get to invite their guests. They get to do their bachelor party, bachelorette party, go on tours. They'll have their hair done, makeup done.
Nice.
They get to choose their dress and have the yes to the dress moment, and Petals and Promises is ready and waiting.
Oh, that's Cara, Mrs. A. Nice.
Yes. And then, of course, we said it's free for everybody. So even the guys with their tuxedos, their bridesmaids, best man, everything is sorted out.
Nice.
So all they need to do is show up with their love and the ring. I'm sorry, we can't do the ring. We can't do the ring.
Freeness stops.
I have to draw the line somewhere.
Yeah, yeah.
But of course, we just need to, we want to share love.
Yeah.
And love is not just in the form of an intimate relationship. This is building of bond between couples as well.
Yeah.
A lot of times we try to encourage couples to, you know, date with other couples, get to understand how other couples live. So you share a community of love, and that's what we want.
Speaking of couples, our lovely bride over here and our lovely groom. First of all, groom, you have your ring already? Because Monique said that don't include it.
It's luck, luck.
Oh, it's a luck. How excited are you guys to have this experience? What are you looking forward to the most? I'll ask that to our bride.
So people can, when they say Mrs. Thomas, it's actually true.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then I have a question for the groom. Sir, do you feel a little bit of pressure? Because normally, for us men, see, I had to come to your rescue just now. I don't even recognize that I came to your rescue when they ask about the ring. Like, I'm saying, he needs time. Don't pressure him. How do you feel? Do you feel pressured going into this, or are you the...
In my head, we've been married.
Yeah. Ah.
So it's not a new relationship or anything. It's about 15 years.
Oh, what? So my next question is, what took you so long? Oh. I'm like, what, wait, is this the same show? Actually, our seated couple now, you guys have also already been selected. What was the thing that made you decide to participate in something like this? I'll direct that to our bride.
So to be honest, you know, I'm in bride mode.
Yes.
I'm preparing. So I was just scrolling on social media and the ad came up. And, you know, I was like, you know, I think this is just a blessing in disguise. I was like, what do I have to lose?
Yeah.
Let me just enter our love story, because I think, you know, it's something that needs to be told. And, you know, I said it to him, you know, babe, I entered us into a competition. He was like, oh, okay. Because in our mind, we never thought that we would, you know, be chosen.
Yeah.
So when I got the call, I was like, oh, okay.
Mm. Yeah.
But it's really a nice feeling. I just want to be able for us to be married so we can, you know, start to spend the rest of our lives together.
Oh, lovely. And that's where you say, yes, honey. Go on.
Yes, honey.
Well done. You take instructions well. No, but fun and joke aside, what are you looking forward to?
Just spending the rest of our lives together.
Yeah.
That's from the moment I met her to this point now, she has been the perfect person for me.
Oh, wow.
And so it's just a matter of spending time with each other.
That's lovely. That's really lovely. And when you hear that, you know, I mean, there's a collective in the room a while ago. But the truth is, Monique, everyone has the perfect person for them. We're not saying that people are perfect, but you have the person that brings out the best in you, that makes you want to grow and be better. And so what you're offering is beautiful, because it allows for the unions to begin in the matrimonial terms. Yeah.
And another truth is that love always wins.
It does. And I also want to stress on the point that love is not stagnant.
Yes.
And so weddings should never be looked at as your final destination.
That's right. It's a start.
It's the start. You have to be able to grow in love. So it's not going to always be this puppy love moment, and it's not going to always be we're in honeymoon phase, because love grows, it matures, and you have to be able to grow with it.
Oh, yeah.
And that is why when we read the stories and we start to look at the stories, it was important to feel the couple in what they were saying. Yeah. It was important to have that trigger that you said, wow, this is just beautiful.
So other couples can still enter?
So they can enter all the way up until March 30th. Okay. We have it fully open. We still have 22 spots remaining, and we invite couples who have a love story. We're searching for you.
How do they enter?
Yes. So how you enter is pretty simple. Follow our Instagram page at MSW Events and share your love story to our email at MSWplanners@gmail.com. Mm-hmm. And share your love story. We have quite a bit, but we want more. Yes. We are in love with love.
Lovely.
And we just want to share it, we want to celebrate it, and we want to do it in true style.
Fantastic. Here's a challenging question for you. Do we have to wait until 2034 for the next one?
If we have to wait then, can you imagine how much more couples I'd be getting married?
That's right. Actually, then you'll probably be marrying the couples who had babies from 2014.
So I'll share that with you. Our couples from 2014 came to our launch that we had at Devon House. Mm-hmm. I mean, sorry, at Hope Gardens, nice. Who is the home for 2014, nice. 2024. Hope Gardens will be flooded with wedding dresses and love and candles and
lovely.
Cake and music.
Sweet. And we can keep doing this. We have to go, but this is fantastic sweet. Stuff. Yes. Really, really nice. Sweet. All right, that was Monique Walcott, the CEO of MSW Events, who brought the altar to Sunrise.
Oh, yeah.
Now, Jason is on standby with Sunrise Freshers. Not an altar, but if you don't want to move a muscle, stick and stay with us. Love it, somebody.